Now, our next guest is Consul Sun Jia from the People's Republic of China Consulate in San Francisco. And I've met him for the first time tonight, but I did get a sneak peek at his slide presentation. I think you're in for a bit of a treat. I think he takes a philosophical perspective on how China views the world, which I think is absolutely critical for us to understand. As the video we watched earlier asked, can we develop the cultural and political bonds to make these projects work, which is so important, because it is a win-win. So please put a warm welcome for Consul Sun Jia.
Chinese perspective. My presentation today is Chinese philosophy behind the Belt and Road Initiative. And Colonel Deng just gave me 10 to 15 minutes, so I just picked up two famous Chinese sayings to answer a couple of questions you may be interested in. But don't worry, I have translated it into English and I'll give you some explanation. The first question is, why China proposed the Belt and Road Initiative? More than 2,000 years ago, an ancient Chinese philosopher Meng Zi said that in the time of hardship, a man should seek self-development through effort of his own, and in the success, one should let others be benefited. It had always been the guideline of Chinese people's daily life and state governance. We believe this is not because it sounds sweet and beautiful, but it has great practical significance. Over the past 40 years, China embarked the reform and opening up, and we have lifted 439 million people out of poverty and made remarkable progress in the area of education, health, and women's welfare. China is now the world's second largest economy following the US. China cannot develop itself in isolation from the rest of of Asia and the world. China needs a peaceful and stable international environment to seek sustainable development. However, today's world is filled with uncertainty. 1.1 million people are shaking off poverty. More than 800 million people are still in starvation. And 1.2 billion people do not have access to electricity. Making contributions to the world peace and prosperity through China's own development is a choice rooted in China's long-term interest as well as the world's interest. What has become of the world and what should we do? China is pondering over these questions and finally proposed the Belt and Road Initiative in 2013. Offering a path of development to eliminate the root cause of conflicts, to protect the basic rights of the people, and to meet the people's yearning for a better life. The Belt and Road Initiative is not a US model nor an EU model, because the situation along the Belt and Road is very different from those in the US and EU. For example, the NAFTA, North American Free Trade Agreement, contains two developed countries, one American and one Canada, and one huge developing country, Mexico. These three economies are very complementary to each other, so it's easy to create NAFTA as one of the world's largest free trade zones and lays fundamental to strong economic growth. However, along the Belt and Road, there are one-third of least developed countries defined by the UN. China has 40 neighboring countries, and the most famous one are North Korea and Afghanistan, rather than Canada and Mexico. I have to say Americans are lucky, but even in this difficult situation, we will not build a row against a war against our neighbors and isolate ourselves. We want to find our way out. Fortunately, China is not only full of energy and goodwill, but also is rich in historical heritage. Over 2,000 years ago, our ancestors opened the intercontinental passage connecting Asia, Europe, and Africa, known today as the Silk Road, and created one sea route linking the East with the West, namely the Maritime Silk Road. They connected the birthplace of Egyptian, Babylonian, Indian, and Chinese civilizations, as well as the lands of Buddhism, Christianity, and Islam, and hosts of people of different races and nationalities. China learned both from the history and the reality, and finally proposed the Belt and Road Initiative in the spirit of peace and cooperation, openness and inclusiveness, mutual learning and mutual benefit. Today, when most of Western scholars are talking about clash of civilizations, we Chinese want to rejuvenate the road that enable different people from different races, civilizations, cultures to react with each other and embrace each other in an open mind. My quick question to why China proposed the Belt and Road Initiative is, our country should pursue prosperity and sustainable development while letting other countries live well. The second question is, why does the Belt and Road Initiative work? Many people think the definition of what project is a Belt and Road project and which country are involved in the Belt and Road Initiative is fuzzy. And some people say it means everything and meanwhile it's nothing. And some people just think it's a political slogan without any concrete actions. There is a sentence from Dao De Jing, a classic Chinese philosopher text, may help us to understand how the Belt and Road Initiative works. That is, best to be like water, which benefits all things and does not contend with them. The Belt and Road Initiative is open to all countries, regardless of size, location, GDP, culture, and so on and so forth. The pursuit of this initiative is based on extensive consultation, so there is no one-size-fits-all policy in this initiative that will help most of the country to reach the common level of life rather than citing regulations, qualifications. The communique of the leaders' roundtable of the Belt and Road Forum for International Cooperation released this May said that we affirm the need to prioritize policy consultation, trade promotion, infrastructure, connectivity, financial cooperation, and people-to-people exchanges, and we highlight concrete actions in accordance with our national law and regulations and international obligations where applicable. So we can see The Belt and Road Initiative is formless and shapeless like water. You put water into a cup, it becomes a cup. You put water into a bottle, it becomes a bottle. And the Belt and Road Initiative in Russia is a Russian style, and the initiative in India is an Indian style. It's not an empty talk. We can see from this slide, the Belt and Road Initiative is becoming reality and bearing rich fruit. From 2013, when the initiative was proposed to now, these 4 years have seen deepened policy coordination, increased trade connectivity, expanded financial cooperation, and strengthened people-to-people exchanges. A solid first step has been taken. China is ready to share its successful practice of development with other countries and already made its commitment and plan. We also welcome international cooperation partners. The Belt and Road Initiative is a new model, as Colonel Deng said, win-win-win cooperation. It will bring true benefit to the world and all human beings. So the answer to the second question is horizontal win-win cooperation of one's own accord is practice of implementing the Belt and Road Initiative. I'm going to end my presentation today with my own definition of the Belt and Road Initiative. Sharing with the wisdom from the East is a plan that China offers the world for seeking common prosperities and development. Thank you. If you want to know more about China and China-US relations, please like our Consulate General's Facebook page. We update this page every several hours and are ready to answer any questions you want. Thank you again.